Ciao, comrades, and welcome! You might have seen the news already. Nintendo DS emulation is now possible on your Miyoo Mini or Plus, running custom on your NOS. I was very excited to see this, and in today's video we are checking out the installation and overall enjoyability. So, let's get cracking! First and foremost, huge thanks to Stuart Fu for making it happen, it's greatly appreciated. Installation is pretty straightforward. Just download the drastic.zip, extract it, put the Drastic folder inside the EMU folder on your SD card, and job done. All is left to do is to create NDS folder inside ROMs and add there all the titles you want to play. Then you just turn on Miyoo Mini and have a blast. And I certainly had a blast trying it out, cause I would have never imagined I would be playing DS games on my Miyoo Mini. But look, where am I now? I'm doing it, and I gotta be honest, it's quite enjoyable. When I first heard the news, there was a game being emulated inside my mind, and its performance was similar like on the PS Vita, maybe a bit better. But I couldn't be more wrong. The games are actually very playable, even audio is quite enjoyable. I think I turned it off in like one game from all I've tried. Certainly it's not perfect. It cannot be, because we are pushing the hardware to its absolute limits. In spite of that, the developer made a great job optimizing the Drastic emulator to run on Onion OS. Thumbs up for that. Clearly, many games are not playable, because they require a lot of touch input. Miyoo Mini doesn't have touchscreen, so we are limited to menus at best. I've tried Legend of Zelda, Phantom Hourglass and the Spirit Tracks, and they are kinda playable. You gotta tap on the characters to talk to them and things like that, but I mean, if you would really want, you can do it. The audio in the cutscene stutters, in the actual gameplay not so much. All the heavy hitters are running solid too. Mario Kart DS, New Super Mario Bros. Super Mario 64 DS. I've enjoyed all of them, even with the audio switched on. I've played it all at default settings, I haven't changed anything. Friendskip was set to automatic. GTA Chinatown Wars, which is a very demanding game, was also playable. The audio kinda sucked, but still I would play it, no issues at all. I've tried also a bunch of other games, like Alien Infestation, Castlevania Dawn of Sorrow, Contra 4, Crash of Titans, Mega Man ZX, Rayman Raving Rabbids, Deblop 2, all were running great. When you press start and select at the same time, you can change the screen orientation, or if you only want to have one screen visible. When you press the function button, the Drastic options will come up. You can save or load game in here, and you can also play with bunch of other settings. I only used R2 and L2. R2 is used for changing screens, and L2 is for bringing up the stylus. Then you would use D-pad for moving it around, and A for selecting what to press. It's kinda intuitive, and it's not hard to do, but you don't really wanna use it that much, you know. Mostly menus or things like that. Now to my final thoughts. I was pleasantly surprised to see how well Plenty games are running. Way above my expectations. Obviously, don't expect all games to be playable. You gotta try what you want and see what it runs like, and then decide whether or not you wanna play it actually. To don't have touchscreen sucks. Still, many games were designed to be playable only with physical buttons, so there is plenty to choose from. To have one screen, it is also not ideal, but I think it's sufficient, as long as we can easily alternate between them, or to have one small screen in the right corner or something. Which we can. All in all, DS emulation on Miyoo Mini is rock solid, and I would recommend every owner to install it. First, you gotta install Onion OS, which is a breeze, so there is no excuse. And it's only gonna get better. If you enjoyed this video, give it a like, subscribe for more. Peace out.